be nice to make a little bit more of him. I know perhaps his life after his kind of creation might be something that people might be interested in hearing about. Yeah. Be a nice idea.
Okay.
Yeah, I noticed that with Quest's slide, Forgiveness of a Chaos Dwarf, where we got the new items, the Dragon Pickaxe, and the boss at the end was just a monster we could want here, it wasn't really a boss. Why haven't there been any new bosses at the end of Quest's recently, and it's been like since one of the seems we've had new bosses that are actually challenging and worth killing? Will there be any in the near future?
I think I disagree slightly. I think we have got a variety of bosses that have some variety to them, but I think one thing we should say is that not every quest, as the lady has said before, needs to be focused around combat. Not every quest needs to have a complex boss fight at the end of it. You know, what these guys are concentrating on is creating a great story. And sometimes a climax is a big fight, sometimes it isn't. Does anybody else want to talk about that? No? Okay.
Okay, use that friendly question. Come out this way. Like I said, are you all right? You having a good day? You good? Good, there you go.
My first question is going to be, when you get given your requirement documents, are you told up front you're going to have to make a list of 7 quests in a big storyline? Or are you just told, there's where it's going to be, leave it open and we'll think in the future, and if it's a short quest, and halfway through you think, this could go on, we can add stuff, is it? Are you given free rein to leave it open so it can be done, or do you go back to a committed story?
Okay, so the question is, how much freedom do we have over the whole story arc of Quest series? John?
It's a mixture. Sometimes you'll be told, this is the start of a 3 Quest series. Although, in that case, it's that definitely would normally be told, maybe it's 3 Quest design piece right now. Sometimes it'll be open, so Mark won't mind with it as a sequel to the developer might want to leave it open or might want to close it. Sometimes we'll be told specifically, this is the start of a new series, we don't know how many quests will be in total, just leave it open. That's what happened with the Goblin series and the originally with Dwarves, although now we've decided to have any Dwarves as you want. Yeah, sometimes developers will say, I want to start the series. And they might have an idea of how they want to finish it, but the plans have to change as they go along. So it's a mixture of all these things.
Yeah, I think we're more worried about starting long-running quest series without a plan how to finish it these days, because obviously there are some that have been left hanging for much longer than we'd like. Which is one reason why more recently we've been working on a series of quests in a row. And in fact, what's a good quest to talk about one of those? Can you answer that?
Well, yes, the recent set of Majorak quests was the first time that I'd been in a group of other developers. We were all told, okay, you need to work together to make a quest series. But one thing you have to watch out for there is that there's a reasonable amount of continuity between the quests, because if you all go off and make whatever you want to, it's not going to work. Happily, I think the Majorak quest series is all really starting to come together now. It can be quite useful. Well, in the past, I've quite liked the idea of you make a quest and you let it sit for a while you think of all the wonderful things that could happen. So it was quite interesting to have to suddenly come up with what's going to happen. But again, Paul Gower helped us with that with the overarching plot, and everything worked out quite nicely.
Quest, Flora's Memories, it was supposed to be a standalone quest, but one of the instructions was don't start a new quest chain with this. So if Mark asks anyone, Flora's Memories is not a continuation of the quest chain for Flora's Memories.
Another question from the
gentleman, actually. Tim, just to follow up on the question earlier, when you did the Tower of Life, was that sort of disco floor with the light up tiles done purely to annoy OCD people or walk around in patterns trying to find some secret?
Disco floor was a strange one. Actually, the reason for it was actually kind of a technical thing to a certain extent, because I was kind of creating that area. I just wanted to try something out that would be kind of really weird and strange. And at the time, we just got a new bit of sort of engine. functionality where we could make, where we could trigger things to happen when you were walking to a certain area. So I thought, I know, I'll just play around with that and have just like the floor or something like that. The thing that was a bit of a shame about that was the audio guy created like a rework of Billie Jean, which is kind of slightly different. We're going to put that in, but unfortunately, we felt we, you know, someone put that down and say, no, we can't put that in. It's gonna avoid some kind of copyright or something like that. So that's a shame. But maybe if I get to do another quest, maybe I'll just like squeeze that one.
All right, thank you.
Okay,
and then down front again.
One fancy, you mentioned that you're a big fan of killing off characters at the moment. Is that like a killing off character at the same time? Is there like a list of negative characters which you're not allowed to kill, or is there a list of characters which are, you know, fair game?
I haven't seen this list. I'm sure if I request to kill someone off, they'll show it to me. I haven't actually requested to kill anyone so far. There are certain ones that we probably wouldn't go near killing off from, based on your reactions to that, and purely technical reasons as well, because it's just so hard. But if anything, while down to sleep, this is a good example, you know, we have no fear of necessarily killing anyone off, because if it's important to the story, we're going to do it.
Now, I remember when Mike was working on that, he did send a request around the team for NPCs that we would be happy to see killed off. Do you want to talk about you and John?
I don't we all, if you pose a question, maybe we all notice we've got different senses of humour, and I don't think I've ever written the Nantes Penguin quest, but I've written funny quests that probably show my own sense of humour, and there's all the members put their own style of quest.
That was one of the unique things about it, that we had a different quest. Writers have their own style, and you get the sense of their own personalities, and they're all very different. You can't really compare Nantes Penguin quest to John's Hobby quest. They're very, very different in tone, very, very different in the sense of humour, but they both work, so it's each to their own.
I think it also depends on what the player wants, because sometimes the player might be in quite a light-hearted mood. Sometimes they might be in a very serious frame of mind. So giving them dialogue options that allow them to choose whether they inject humour or not is a nice touch too, I think.
I think one thing as well is with RuneScape, it's quite, in a lot of places, quite like sort of light-hearted. It's not like lots of other games you get where it's really gritty and real, and you know, you're going around and shooting people, blowing people up and stuff like that. It has the same level of violence, I suppose. But it means that when you try to actually write something that's quite serious and it's quite, you know, deep and dramatic, it's actually probably a little bit more tricky sometimes because of that kind of light-hearted nature that you have. It means that comedy often kind of, I think, it lends itself pretty well to RuneScape.
It's very easy to write, it's very easy to write comedy in the moment, not have it in advance, but you just think of a joke you're putting right now. And in the chosen command a way that stop myself doing that, actually, beyond this point of the quest, no humour. To get the ending I did, because I've had tons of things like that.
Okay?
It's human, though.